Hello again, here is Dark Rivoon, so ready to continue Mass Effect 2. So let's head to that Eclipse Mercs in order to clean the path for Samara not to leave with us.
I'll tear you apart.
Down.
I'll be gone.
One more deal.
Oh, there is something here.
If they do see me, don't let them kill me. Tended to because the other Eclipse sisters were watching, but I didn't really shoot.
Whatever. Pretend to keep breathing.
I'm not one of them. I'm new. I thought being Elnora the mercenary would be cool, but I didn't know what they were really like.
You chose your side, Elnora. And you lost.
Screw that bastard and screw you!
And screw you.
This is valuable. We've been spotted.
Oh yeah, I remember that battle. This will be hard.
Detective would want this.
Yeah, they will definitely want this. And it's the thing, you can spare her life, but as I played a couple of games, I know that she's escaping if I don't kill her, so she's escaping, and then, well, I figure out that I was a dummy. So this time around, I just killed her.
They've seen us.
Down.
And here is the big fight.
Gunship above.
Well, thanks to that mega overpowered weapon I just killed him, but it would have been a really more difficult fight.
This looks like a shipping manifest. It shows the Pitney IV sold 2,000 units of Minigen X3 to the Eclipse, along with 600 units of Red Sand.
This isn't the information Samara needs, but it proves the Volus is a criminal.
Valuable information to the Volus.
We've got to keep moving.
Little bastard.
God, I think things, and they happen. Fear me, lesser creatures, for I am biotics made flesh.
I don't know what drugs you're on, but stay back and I won't shoot you.
You will regret your scandalous words. I am a great wind that will sweep all before me like a great wind. A great biotic wind. Yes, the Asari injecting so many drugs into me was terrifying. But then I began to smell my greatness. They may laugh when I fall over, but they don't know what I know in my head. That I know that I am amazingly powerful. Fear me!
Good luck with everything.
Wait, Earth Clan. You're just in time to witness my crowning achievement. The leader of the mercenaries is in the next room. I shall toss Wasaya about like a rag doll.
This idiot is no challenge to anyone.
I will tear her apart. My biotics are unstoppable.
Wasaya will tear you apart. Take a nap. You'll feel better.
Are you mad? I'm unstoppable. Feasting on her biotic-rich blood will be the last step. But, great wind, biotic god, I'm... What was I saying? I'm tired. You may be right. Yes, I'm tired. I'll nap. Destroy the universe later.
Useless.
And grunt. He's all right.
Right.
Everything's gone to hell since we smuggled that filthy creature off-world. First Adjusticar shows up. Now you. At least I can take pleasure in turning your head into a pulpy mass!
Oh, I think Grun just killed her by himself. What a fucking badass, Krogan.
I'll put them down!
Some record of that ship must be around here.
That the ship the crazy Asari wanted to find?
Should we head back to the police station and give her the name, or look around first?
Let's give her the name and keep moving.
I wanted to be a Justicar when I was young.
Thank you for removing the Eclipse threat, Earth Clan. It will take them months to rebuild their organization. Also, merely out of curiosity, when you were poking about, did you perhaps run across a shipping manifest that belongs to me?
You never know when something like this might come in handy.
If it might change your mind, Earth Clan, returning that manifest would be very profitable for you. If you give it to the detective, her reward will be a pat on the back.
Yeah, I don't know that manifest what it will be, but yeah, most probably I'll just keep it like he mentioned.
If you have something that'll encourage the Justicar to leave, show it to her.
I've got the name of the ship. Your fugitive left here 2 days ago on the AML Demeter.
Shepard, you impress me. You fulfilled your part of the bargain, and I will fulfill mine. I'm ready to leave immediately, if that will satisfy your superiors, Detective.
You're free to go, Justicar. It has been an honor having you in my station. And it's nice you didn't kill me, too.
The The Normandy is docked near the main trading floor. I'll see you aboard.
I must be sworn to your service so that I am never forced to choose between your orders and the code. By the code, I will serve you, Shepard. Your choices are my choices. Your morals are my morals. Your wishes are my code.
I never thought I'd see a Justicar swear an oath like that.
If you make me do anything extremely dishonorable, I may need to kill you when I'm released from my oath.
You'll be a great asset to our mission. I'm excited to have you along.
I am glad to hear it. I will fight by your side, kill your enemies, and protect your friends. Shall we return to your ship?
Let's go.
Welcome to the Normandy, Samara. We've studied your profile extensively. With your skills, I think you'll be an excellent addition to our team.
Thank you. From an organization such as yours, that is high praise indeed.
I've seen Samara's biotic powers at work. They're substantial.
We still don't know what we're going to find when we hit the collectors.
I will be prepared for whatever we encounter.
Where shall we put you?
A room that looks out on the great empty void would be most comforting.
Put her in the observation room on deck 3.
Thank you. I must meditate on the day's events.
Well, there we go. So far we have finished our missions in Ilium. And I might buy something from there, but still. We are ready to, you know, speak a little bit with the crew, especially with Miranda, which wanted to speak with me.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Shepard, I find myself in the unpleasant position of asking for your help. I don't like discussing personal matters, but this is important.
Miranda, you're one of my crew. Tell me what's on your mind.
You remember what I told you about Father, building a dynasty? There was another reason I went to Cerberus for protection. I have a sister, a twin, and he's still hunting her. Cerberus has kept her safe, until now. She's living a normal life on Ilium, safe and hidden from my father.
So you think your father has tracked her down?
Precisely, Commander. My sources indicate he knows that she's on Ilium. I've tried to keep her hidden without impacting her life, but I'm out of options. He's too close. I need to relocate my sister's family before it's too late.
What do you know about your sister?
She's my genetic twin. We're identical, but she deserves a normal life, and she's going to get it no matter what.
Does your sister's family know about this? Are they okay with being relocated?
They know nothing. They're completely uninvolved. Normal. I told Cerberus, and they're coming up with a positive reason to move the family.
What do you need me to do?
My father is extremely persistent. I'd like to go to Ilium when Cerberus is moving the family to make sure none of his agents get too close. My contact's name is Lantea. She'll be waiting for us in the lounge near the Nos Astra docking bay.
Right, well, seems like we're not moving from Ilium anytime soon. So, yeah. We'll be just speaking a little bit with her if possible.
If we have time, I'd like to go to Ilium and relocate my sister's family.
I'll let you know, Miranda.
Of course, Commander.
So it seems like there will be no more options to speak with her unless we go to that mission.
Good in a long time.
I didn't think Rupert had it in him.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Can it wait for a bit? I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
The calibrations of Garrus.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
I'll be here if you need me.
So the collectors did take New Canton?
Yes, but my wife and daughter left in the nick of time. They're resting in San Francisco as we speak.
That's great news.
It is. But I knew a lot of good people in New Canton. Our mission has to succeed.
Thank God Shepard's in command.
Shepard.
Do you have any suggestions about using some of the resources we've gathered?
I believe I can use some of them to increase our fuel reserves so we can explore further. Shall I tell you what is required?
Show me what it would take.
Shepard.
What are your impressions of Miranda and Jacob?
Jacob is an earnest young man. Events will either forge him into a great man or utterly destroy him. Miranda is undoubtedly a hard woman. I respect her strength and determination. She carries many burdens and doesn't share them with others, as it should be.
How do you think our mission is going?
Building our forces is a good strategy. However, the time to strike is coming soon.
Do you have any suggestions about using some of the resources we've gathered?
I have done what I can to increase our exploration capabilities. Anything beyond that is up to you.
How are you?
I've spent much of the last 400 years on my own. It is nice to have a colleague to chat with. I may be rusty at it, however. If you are patient, I would love to talk.
How much do you know about our mission?
I know that I've sworn an oath to follow you. And that you seek to destroy the Collectors. That is enough for me.
You don't want to know why the Collectors need to be fought?
When you live by a code that compels you to harsh action, you learn the dangers of curiosity. If I must kill a man because he has done wrong, do I really wish to know that he is a devoted father?
There is a point in there, yeah.
I'd like to hear more about the criminal you were chasing on Nos Astra.
I hope you will understand if I wish to avoid this topic. It is deeply tied to my code and beliefs. You might say it is personal.
What do you think of Cerberus?
I've heard rumors, but learned long ago to form my own impressions. There is too much room for interpretation in the opinions of others.
Why were you willing to work for Cerberus when you didn't have first-hand knowledge?
I work for you, Shepard. Our methods may be different, but our goals are not.
I should get back to work.
It has been my pleasure, Commander.
There you are. Liara Tassoni's got quite a reputation. I've done business with her people before. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way. I have to say, that Jacob? He seems pretty intense. I wonder if he likes Japanese girls with a penchant for kleptomania. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Do you need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Certainly. We haven't had a chance since I joined.
When we met you, you said you were dying.
Yes. I thought you'd want to know more. You don't have to worry about the rest of the crew. My illness is not communicable, even to other Drell. It's called Kepril syndrome.
Is there anything we can do here? Normandy has a state-of-the-art medical bay.
No, thank you. It's being attended to. If the finest medical minds in the Hanar Illuminated Primacy can't solve the problem, I doubt your ship's medic could. Thank you for your concern. Trust me, this won't affect my performance. Do you need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Later. I'd like to consider what we've already discussed.
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
We need to have the best equipment possible to take on the Collectors. You have any leads I could chase down?
My old contact network often located rare equipment for me. Would you like me to get in touch with them?
Let's see what they've got.
There goes our probes. Now we'll have like 60 probes instead of 30, which is better.
Do you need something?
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
We need to have the best equipment possible to take on the Collectors. You have any leads I could chase down?
I've already upgraded the Normandy's exploration probes. I have no additional suggestions.
The Drell live on the Hanar homeworld, don't they?
Yes. I know many think the Hanar difficult to understand. It's just that they're very formal with those they don't know. We know them quite well. If you ever get close enough to a Hanar that they tell you their soul name, you would find them warm.
I thought that Hanar only let very close friends know their soul name.
Most of my commissions were for Hanar. I grew close to my regular contacts. Soul names tend to be poetic. A Hanar known for its cynicism might take a name that means illuminates the folly of the dancers.
Hanar talk using bioluminescence. That's more of an obstacle than their politeness.
True. Many Drell have had their eyes genetically modified to perceive their higher frequency flashes. I had the treatment. I can't tell the difference between a dark red and black, but I can see ultraviolet light as a silver color.
When you pray for the wicked, who exactly are you praying to?
That depends on the circumstance. To find my target, I speak with Amonkira, Lord of Hunters. When I act to defend another, Arashu, Goddess of Motherhood and Protection. And when I have taken my target, I speak with Kalahira, Goddess of Oceans and the Afterlife.
I didn't know that Drell had many gods.
It's one of our older beliefs. Many embrace the Hanar and Kindlers now, or the Asari philosophies. The old ways are dying. There are so many ways to interpret one's place in the universe. Who needs the wisdom of our ancestors? The younger generations don't believe they can help us fathom genetic engineering, orbital strikes, or alien races.
There's something else I'd like to talk about.
Ask.
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
Well, it seems that these are the questions. Well, this is Dain Krios.
I should go.
I shall return to my meditations.
So, yeah, we'll stop the video here, and on my next one we'll continue to speak with the crew, and after that, well, we might do our first loyalty mission, the one of Miranda. So thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed. Dark Rune out.